गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज मैरिज. नाउ आई विल डिस्कस द मैरिज अंडर द हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट 1955. द हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट वॉज इनेक्टेड बाय द पार्लियामेंट इन 1955 टू अमेंड एंड कोडिफाई द मैरिज. नाउ वट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट. The Hindu Marriage Act was enacted by Parliament in 1955 to amend and to codify marriage between Hindus. It also regulates other aspects of personal life among Hindus. A Hindu Marriage Act provides guidance for Hindus to be in a systematic marriage bond. This is the concept of the Hindu Marriage Act. Now, what is the meaning of marriage? The marriage defines the rights, duties and privileges of husband and wife. Now, what is the actual meaning of the marriage? According to the Lundberg, marriage consists of the rules and regulations which defines the rights, duties and privileges of husband and wife with respect to each other. Now, what is the essential elements regarding the marriage? What is the nature of marriage and what is the characteristics of the marriage? Marriage consists of three characteristics. The marriage, first one is the marriage is a permanent union. Second one is the marriage is an eternal union. And third one, it is an holy union. What is the meaning of permanent union? Permanent union means once tied cannot be untied. Eternal union means valid not only in this life but in lives to come. Holy union describes performance of religious ceremonies is essential. These three characteristics of the marriage is essentials under the marriage. In Gopala Krishna versus Mithilesh Kumar, AIR 1979, in this case, the Allahabad High Court laid down that the institution of matrimony under the Hindu law is a sacrament, not a mere socio-legal contract. In another case, Mathu Swami versus Mashila Mani, the court has observed a marriage, whatever else it is, a sacrament or an institution, is undoubtedly a contract entered into for consideration with correlative rights and duties. Now, conditions of a marriage, essential conditions of a valid marriage. There are five essential conditions for a marriage. First one is monogamy, second is mental issue, third is age, fourth is prohibited relationship, and fifth one is sapinda relationship. As per section 5, these five conditions must be fulfilled. The section 5 clause 1, conditions of monogamy, clause 2, conditions regarding mental health or capacity, clause 3, conditions of marriageable as age, clause 4, avoidance of degree of prohibited relationship, clause 5, avoidance of sapinda relationship. These five conditions must be fulfilled at the time of marriage under Hindu Marriage Act 1955. Now we will talk about the clause 1, condition of monogamy. This condition basically implies monogamy and prohibit bigamy or polygamy. It means neither party has a spouse living at the time of marriage. The expression neither party has a spouse living depicts that the spouse must not be alive at the time of marriage. If the spouse is alive at the time of marriage, that could bar the remarriage of a person. One must note that the first marriage of a person should be legally valid marriage. In spite of one's valid marriage, if the person remarries in violation of section 5 clause 1, if any person is violating Section 5, Clause 1 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955, the second marriage will be null and void and he will be subjected to penal consequences. Section 17 makes it a penal offense of Hindu Marriage Act for both male and female and under IPC Section 494 and 495. In case of a bigamous marriage, the second wife has no status of wife. Now, Section 5, Clause 1 prohibits bigamy or polygamy. Section 11 makes a bigamous marriage void. And Section 17 makes it a penal offense for both Hindus, male and females under Section 494 and 495 of IPC. In case of Bagodi and others versus Pidama and others, AIR 2006 Supreme Court 149. In this case, the court held that during the subsistence of first marriage, the second marriage would be null and void. As per Section 5, Clause 1 of Hindu Marriage Act, if the first marriage is a valid marriage, the second marriage would be treated as null and void. Now, in the case of A.N. Mukherjee versus State, AIR 1969, A.L. 489, offense of bigamy would be constituted only when the first marriage is solemnized according to proper ceremonies and rituals. Thank you.